Good morning, Black people, with Morgan Rees. And I am your host, the beautiful, the fun, the loving Morgan Rees. Tonight is a special event tonight, a special honor that I am going to be introducing and speaking with and interviewing the amazing Buff Dillard, the international recording artist and trombonist Buff Dillard. Guys, this is a treat for me. It's a blessing and an honor that he took out the time to want to interview with me on my debut. A good morning, Black people, with Morgan Rees. Again, my name is Morgan Rees, and I want to talk to you a little bit more about Buff. Buff is a native of Greenville, South Carolina. He has worked with many Grammy award-winning artists and producers. He was featured as a soloist on Pastor John P. Key's Strength and New Divine Destiny projects. He has also shared the stage with other award winners, award-winning gospel artists such as Helen Baylor and the William Brothers. Ooh. During his musical career, he has opened for iconic artists such as Peaches of a Dream, Count Basie Orchestra, Boney James, Alex Bugman, Walter Beasley, Kim Walters, Brian Simpson, Nick Kalani, Ben Tankard, as well as R&B legends such as the SOS Band, Jasmine Sullivan, Kevin Edmonds, Faith Evans, and Glenn Lewis. Well, guys, that's just a piece of his resume. I am so honored to welcome my guest. So everyone join me in welcoming Buff Dillard. Hello, Buff.
Hello there. How you doing?
I am wonderful. I am so blessed and honored that you took out the time out of your busy schedule to join me this evening on my debut on my new show, Good Morning Black People with Morgan Rees.
Thanks for having me. I really appreciate it, Morgan. It's the pleasure is all mine.
Anytime. Well, guys, I love talking to me, listening to me. Buff, please tell everyone exactly who you are. I gave a brief bio of you, but I want it really coming from you directly. I promise you, you are a gifted and talented human being. And share with everyone who you are.
Well, thank you very much. I really appreciate it. I am just somebody trying to tell everybody about somebody. I'm just, that's the way the song goes. But
I know that song.
I am humbled, a blessed human being that's have been gifted this talent to share with the world. In the industry, in every industry, people, you know, they drift. They give so much meaning to the accolades and the accomplishments and the names. I'm not big on the names. I do that stuff because it's on my website because I have to have it on my website. It's a lot of artists that I perform with. I'll start with the testimony. The testimony that makes me different from any other artist, wind instrument artist, is the fact that I was born with chronic asthma, diagnosed with chronic asthma. And when people find that out, they have no idea. They have no idea, but then they really have no idea how I'm able to play a bass wind instrument. And I've been doing it since the age of 5 years old. I could barely hold it, but I was putting wind and a note was coming out. And so that's the real testimony behind the passion. It's never been name and fame. It's never been money. Of course, that's what makes the world go round. But it's always been the passion and giving back and then giving thanks to Yahuwah, who gives me the energy and divine purpose to minister to people through melodic therapy and my instrument. So anytime I get invitation such as yours, when I can, I try to say yes and do my best to put that out there, because people need to know who the Most High is and the power that they possess, okay, as human beings, once they channel the energy. That's what it's really all about.
Wow. You definitely said a mouthful right there. Gosh, I'm speechless right now because I have asthma. I didn't know you had asthma. So I definitely know what your struggle is. Man. Gosh, you are definitely a true testament. I have seen you perform live myself, and you really do have a gift that God has given you. You are an amazing young man. I promise you're amazing. And I know people probably tell you that all the time, but I am appreciative and grateful of your humble spirit. And that's what God asks us to be at all times, is humble. And I promise you, your blessing is going to go further and more, because my slogan this year is 2023 is all about me. So that's what you need to say for the rest of the year. 2023 is all about who?
All about you.
Nope, all about you. Don't do it, Bob. Don't do it. You're not switching that around. You're not switching that around. I knew you was going to do that. I don't even know why I knew you were going to do that, but I think you were going to do that.
I'm going to tell you what, Morgan, I am my biggest critic. And I'll tell everybody, I minister to people in language all the time, not just so the instrument is so powerful. The music is so powerful. It's not the artist. Artists think it's them a lot of the times, but it's not the artist. It's the divine within that comes out to touch souls. That's what I'm built on. So with that being said, like, when I say I'm nobody, I know I'm somebody, but I remain humble. My parents taught me to be humble. I have issues just like everybody else, from the president to Jay-Z, to Beyonce, you name the biggest artist, name the biggest political figure, the biggest pastor. Look, we all put our pants on the same way. We all have issues that we fight every single day. My prayer every day when I hit my feet hit the ground is, Yahuwah, I thank you for all that you have done in my life. I thank you for all that you're about to do in my life. I thank you for another chance to be better today than I was yesterday. We get a chance when we wake up, we get a chance to start over. We as people, as humans, we're so hard on each other. And that hurts me. It really bothers me. And that's what people don't know about me. And I'm starting to air it more and more on different shows and podcasts and television interviews and radio. That's who I really am. Like, I really genuinely care about people. And it would be so awesome if we could just focus on us. You don't have time to be somebody else or worry about what somebody else is doing. If you focus on yourself and perfect your craft, then you'll find favor.
From your lips to God's ears, I promise you, I'm on your coattail doing the same thing. That's why when I was blessed to have this opportunity to do a podcast, and I said, this is a real raw podcast. It's going to be respectful. It's going to be honest. It's going to be open, because that's who I've always been. And I've learned myself as I've gotten older to be more open. And you, promise you, you said a mouthful, Buff. Awesome. But guess what, Buff? You might have to do something for me.
What we doing?
You're going to have to go ahead and give us a piece. Give us a little sample of that gift that God gave. You didn't think I was going to do that. I told you.
No, because I don't know how it's going to sound. How does my voice sound?
Your voice sounds amazing. You sound really, look, you're the rest in peace, late Barry White voice.
You know what?
I'm just look. There you go. I heard that. Ladies, calm down. He's married. Leave him alone.
But I don't know if I can. I'm trying to think of a song. I'll do a piece of something, because I know we're pressed for time. I would love to, if I had known and we could have done a sound check, I would have done something original, because I am that artist that creates, and I love to put my own music out there. But I'm going to do something that everybody, from an artist that everybody know, Stevie Wonder, just a little piece of Isn't She Lovely. Let me see if I can tune it. You can't, this ain't the kind of horn, sweetheart, you can just pick up and start playing.
I just know that you're so talented, and God gave you so much of those blessings and that grace that you got this. So I have much more confidence than you think I do in you.
Okay, I'm going to do a little bit of this song. I'm not going to do the whole song.
That's fine.
Just for you.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you. Yeah, it was better than what you thought it was, Buff. That sounds clear.
I can't hear it. So,
well, I can only hear in one ear, but my one good ear heard that. And it sounded just like it did when I was watching you live.
But thank you.
I knew you were ready because you had it right behind you. That's why I put you on the spot like that.
I always look. It's the whole family here. I got like five of them in here.
Mm-hmm. So
I am sitting in my music room. This is where a lot of the magic happens. Mm-hmm. And we produce music and record. And the tracks that I play on my live shows, if anybody's really paying attention, they're enhanced. I'm singing the background lyrics. I'm singing hooks. I got extra horns in it because my will has always to be Buff Dillard, be nobody else, but be Buff Dillard and be unique. So my product is not like any other product that you hear anywhere else. So all that kind of stuff happens right here in this room. I just couldn't hear on your side what it sounded like.
I promise you, once you hear that replay and everybody else listen to you, they're gonna be like, okay, Buff, I don't know what you was talking about.
Yeah, I didn't get a chance to warm up, but I hope it sounded okay.
Oh, it sounded amazing. You got a gift. When you got a gift, it's like riding a bike. You never forget, and it comes natural. I'm just saying. Yeah, I'm 49 you. Years old, and I can still go on a bike and ride. I may not stay on as long as I used to. But I can still. How long have you been in this business? How long your passion? Because I see it's a passion. I saw that when I first met you.
I've been playing the trombone since I was five. Really playing like music as a soloist. I started right about seven years old. I've been in the music industry a little over 35 years. Actually, it's probably about 38 years now. And that includes playing with other artists, as well as going out solo and doing what I do abroad, all over the country. Wherever there's an invite, I'm independent. I will take a number of festivals, jazz festivals, still do. But my most favorite shows are the intimate shows where I can connect with the audience a little bit better. Yeah. Yeah. So yeah, wow. I've been at it a while.
Man, you know what? You got a lot longer in you, so don't even worry about it. You're not going away no time soon. God has a ministry. This is your ministry. I look at this like as your ministry. I always tell people healing is in music.
It is.
And you could be sad, you could be happy, you can be upset, you could be disappointed, and you'll find that right song that has those right lyrics or those right meaning, or it may even have the right beat, and you're feeling whatever you're feeling, and it's in that music. And you have that gift with your music. And because you are unique on purpose, man, that's an added bonus. That's an added bonus.
Thank you so much. I do teach that to the youth and other artists that's coming up. That there are some artists that have performed on stage with me, have asked to perform on stage with me that haven't broke out, that have gone much further than where I am. They have record deals. They're touring. They're playing with people all. I mean, you don't ever see them again. But for me to be able to minister to them and have them to understand what it really is, it's really all about frequency. And then they take that and run with it. I'm leaving legacy. I'm cool with it.
Well, Buff Dillard, while you're on this heavenly, when you're on this natural earth and then moving to the heavenly earth, Buff Dillard is going to be in everyone's heart, mind, and spirit. I promise you they are. Well, Buff, can you tell everyone how to meet with you, how to connect with you, any shows that you have upcoming in? I know you're in North Carolina. I've seen a list of shows. You are really, really busy. So if you can give us like a little rundown, like the next month between now and Valentine's Day, or maybe next, give us some shows that someone can catch you at, whether you're local, whether you're.
So I perform on what I called, I don't know if anybody else was doing this. I was just having a conversation with a really good friend of mine, B. Wright, detailing. He was detailing my car this morning. And I was telling him, I had this grand idea. I got to plug this in. There are certain venues that a lot of artists won't, well, some artists won't go because they can't deal with it. Now, this is crazy. Most in it, the smoke lounges, it's the lounges. I perform in those lounges, and I told you what I was diagnosed with. I don't claim it, but I was struggling as a kid growing up, and sometimes as an adult, it don't even bother me. It don't bother me. I've never come home. I've performed in those lounges for a year and been able to make a living. So I'm blessed to be able to do that. And it, you know, y'all will put up a shield where I'm not bothered. But you can catch me on what I call the local circuit, the metro circuit. Ash and Barrel and Cornelius, I perform there at least twice a month. Whiskars is another one. And I perform there in Gastonia probably 2 to 3 times a month, my solo act, both of those two. What I like about Whiskars is they have a no smoke room. So I actually perform where the bar is in the lounge. You smoke in a whole nother room in the back. So it's a very nice place. Let's see who else. Smoke and Barrel is the biggest. I have my full band there as of now all the time. I subcontract musicians. You never know who's going to be behind me, but I have some elite musicians in the area that I shout out all of you that have ever played with me. Love you. Thank you so much for your support. We're there. It used to be twice a month last year. As of November, the owner booked me every week throughout the rest of the year. That's they've already booked me. Whiskars have already booked me the whole year. City Cellar in Lincolnton is another venue I'm at every last Friday. They have booked me for the rest of the year. Vibes is a place that's Vibes Bar and Grill in Kannapolis in Cloverleaf. It's actually on Cloverleaf Parkway in Kannapolis. They have booked me for the rest of the year. I'll be there every first Wednesday. Last week I was in Maryland. From time to time I travel. I'm in Maryland doing things for the Navy and their functions, whatever that is. Sometimes it's promotion, sometimes it's just, I just did a holiday party. It's late, but did a holiday party last week. Flew up, stayed for 4 days, came back, get back on this circuit. This week, I'll be at Smoke and Barrel Thursday in Mount Holly. I will be in Sumter, South Carolina on Friday, playing at Morris College for their faculty. And then Saturday, I'm at Whiskars in Gastonia. And then Sunday, I'm at Reds on Union. That's another place. They have booked me throughout the rest of the year in Concord, North Carolina. It's a soul food restaurant. Awesome food. It's on Union Street in Concord, North Carolina. There is no cover charge. So, yeah, we start to get busy like Wednesday.
2023 through Saturday. Is your year. What did I say? 2023 is all about who?
It's you.
No, you can't keep switching.
It's all about him.
It's all about him. You're right. But it's all about you and us because of him.
Yeah, within.
Amen, amen. Can you give us your website and any social media platforms where everyone can follow you at?
Sure. My website is a little tricky, but it's buffdillardmusic.card with 2 R's. CARRD.co. buffdillardmusic.card with 2 R's.co is the website. You can find everything there, from the bio to clips to accolades from other people that I perform for, promoters, whatnot. Let me go ahead and finish on I gotta say this because it's a really, really good friend of mine.
Let it out.
We go way back, and I will mention this. She may not be listening, but I'm still going to put it out there. But on Facebook, you want to follow me. I can't have any more friends. follow me at Buff Dillard Music. You can also follow me on the group page. It's the fan page. It's called Buff Dillard Connection. Okay. If you type in Buff Dillard Connection and join, you will always be in the know.
Okay.
Hey, check out my website. Hey, okay. So let's see. Producer is on it.
Is all about Buff.
Producer is on it. Producer is on it. And let's see. Instagram, Buff_Dillard_music. It's Buff Dillard Music LinkedIn, Buff Dillard Music TikTok, Buff Dillard Music on, let me see, that was all of them, Twitter. So yeah, you look me up, you'll see my picture. I appreciate it if everybody could follow me. What I was going to say is, last night I got a text while I was performing at Ashton Barrow. Oh my gosh, here it is right here. January 28th. At 1:30 p.m., Aussie and Martin Rivers. Now, I don't know if everybody remember. I don't even know if you remember, but that was a very, very well-known household name, radio personality by the name of Tanya Rivens.
Oh.
I said Rivers. I meant Rivens.
Long time ago. I'm not that old, but I'm not that young either.
She is still doing her thing, and she has a scholarship. Launching award. She texted me last night while I was on stage. I immediately hear her back because I just love what she do. Her and her family are awesome. We've all been friends for so long, but she has a nonprofit. It's a scholarship awards launching. It's going to be at North Mech Recreation Center. And I think it's in Huntersville. I'm pretty sure. Statesville Road. Yeah. North Mech Recreation Rec Center.
Okay.
18821 Old Statesville Road in Cornelius. Okay. That's Saturday. I was already booked for Saturday, but I'm doing two shows Saturday. So I'm a double header. I'll be at this function playing for her and her nonprofit. Then later, like 9 to 12, we'll be at Whiskars.
Give us her name again one more time.
Her name is Tanya Rivens. The name,
R-I-V-E-N-S.
R-I-V-E-N-S. Yes. And it's the scholarship awards luncheon for Aussie and Martin Rivens.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, yeah, I do a lot of stuff in the community every time I get a chance with Mr. Excitement and his crew. And anybody else that would call, you know, I try to give back as much as possible because that's where the true blessings come from.
Wow. Buff. Well, I have a request. I would like for you to come back to my show again another time when you're not so busy. Would you do that for me, Buff? If you're not so busy.
I will do everything I can. You send me the date. We'll schedule it just like we did this time and we'll make it happen.
And this time we'll do a little longer performance so they can be able to really hear the true natural version, the gifted, unique version of Buff Dillard live on air on my show. Oh my gosh, Buff, you are a godsend. I promise you are. From my lips to God's ears, he answers blessings at all times. I promise you he do.
Thank you, sir.
I promise you he do.
I am guys,
oh my gosh, it's a treat. I'm not going to get emotional because people who know me personally know I can get a little cry, baby, but I ain't going to do that because I'm like, it's all happy tears. I promise you, it's all happy tears. It's never going to be sad tears. But Buff, again, it was an honor. I promise you, it was an honor and a blessing to have you to take the time. I know you are a busy, busy man. And what I always say is when you're that busy, that means there's all those blessings are following right behind you. All those accolades is following right behind you.
So I received that.
Don't stop what you're doing. Just keep. I say, don't stop. Get it. Don't stop. Get it. You are such a unique young man. From the first time I met you, and I promise you, for me to be where I'm at right now, to even interview you, I am humbled. I am blessed. I am grateful and thankful for you to take the time out. Well, guys, I just want to say thank you again, Buff. I promise you, wherever you are, I hope you are watching this. You can watch it in the morning, the afternoon, evening. Listen to it again. Oh my gosh, I am blessed. I'm grateful that God has allowed me to be able to interview Buff Dillard. You guys, listen, the other words coming out of my mouth. His name is Buff Dillard, the trombonist, the international recording artist, who is such a humble young man, who has an amazing gift that he's sharing with the world. And I'm telling you from my lips to you guys' ears, he's going to bless you 10 times over. You think you got busy schedule now. This ain't over. You about to blow up to a whole other level, young man. You about to blow up to a whole other level. Go ahead and receive it.
I receive.
Is there anything else you would like to share with our viewers and our people who are watching us tonight?
You have totally... I want everyone under the sound of my voice to please continue to keep this sister right here, Morgan Rees, in prayer, and that she continues to do the work that she has set out to do to make a difference in the community and bringing forth good media. That's a lot of bad media out there, but she's bringing forth good media, and that's what we need more of, the positive, not the negative. Other than that, you have allowed me to say everything that I needed to say tonight, and hopefully I'll see you guys somewhere down the road. Y'all keep the passion.
You definitely will see me somewhere down the road. You'll be like, oh, here she comes. Like, I know him. I know him. I cannot wait to see you again in person, to hear you perform wherever you are in the Charlotte area, in the Mooresville, Gastonia. Y'all heard all his plugs. He's even going to Maryland. This man is moving. He's flowing. And 2023... it's only January 23rd, 2023 at officially 6:28 p.m. a.m. afternoon, wherever you at, what station, where part of the world you at. Buff Dillard took the time to come and see me. So he got a whole list of things for the rest of the year. He's going to have some other stuff added to it. But guys, please listen to him. Here, take some of his words of wisdom. He's such a wise man. He's so humble. And that's a saying a lot, because a lot of men go through a lot, deal with a lot. And when they share that humble side of them, some people think it's a weak side. To me, I think it's strong, because God gave you that strength and that wisdom and that courage to be this person. So whoever can listen, they're going to listen. And if they don't listen, when they say a cry out to the rocks will listen. It don't even matter. It's been said out in the atmosphere, so it won't even matter. But guys, again, thank you for listening and taking the time, Buff, for coming to see me and joining and gracing me with your presence and with your gift and sharing some of that good music you have. And please follow him on all his social media platforms and check him out live. He's better live, I promise you. He's better live, I promise you. He's amazing online. When you have that one-on-one experience with Buff Dillard, you get an experience where you go home and you just soak it in. Buff, thank you again for coming on my show. Again, guys, please check Buff out on all the social media platforms that he's on. Check him out on his website and listen to good, clean, honest, wholesome music. That's what's going to feed your soul. Thank you for coming on Good Morning Black People with Morgan Rees. Buff, you are a blessing to me, I promise you. And I look forward to us meeting again. And guys, thank you again for joining my show. Till the next time, Good Morning Black People with Morgan Rees, because 2023 is all about who?
Me
and you. Love you so much, Buff. And I'm so
love you too.
I'm so grateful. And love, we'll do too. This again. Goodbye, thank everyone. You. Have a good evening. Have a good morning. Have a good night. Afternoon, wherever you
This March, joining the She Said Yes to Herself Unapologetically Summit, six-time best-selling author, the teacher and preacher. She is the consummate relationship coach. It's the one and only Dr. Velma Bagby, author, podcasting host, preacher, speaker, teacher, and relationship coach. It's Dr. Velma Bagby. Join her this March as she hosts the second annual She Said Yes to Herself Unapologetically Summit, March 7th and 8th. So if you've missed her in the past, if you have wondered where you can hear or see this dynamic woman of God, get ready for the She Said Yes to Herself Unapologetically Summit, where Dr. Velma Bagby will be hosting. This is a conference that you don't want to miss.